Hello everybody, Harry here from Joiin. Shortly I'll be running you through a demonstration of the Joiin product, showing you how easy, quick and simple it is to set up your Joiin account, connect your Xero, QuickBooks and Sage companies, and begin running consolidated financial reports. So we'll now head over to the Joiin platform to begin the demonstration.
To begin, I'll show you how you can add your companies to Joiin. So we're on the Joiin companies page, and we can head on over to this bit over here, which says add company, which we can click on. And we can choose to connect to Xero, QuickBooks or Sage. If we were to choose one of those options, we'd be redirected to a secure sign-in for those. Or we can add data manually. So that's if you want to upload data from exterior software, you can do that via Excel. So I'll come off that one quickly. And just to let you know that the data tends to take kind of 1 to 2 minutes to upload for the first time. And then we'll update every 24 hours after that to keep it nice and fresh. So next we'll go on over to our off-the-shelf report. So I'm going to open up this profit and loss report, and I'm going to build it up from a single entity report into a group level consolidated financial statement. So to begin, we can choose which companies to include in the report. So currently we have this Joiin Limited company, and then these are the rest of the companies in my group, and I'm just going to select Saltram for the time being, and I'm going to apply those changes, and as I go through, Joiin will continue to run the reports for me to update it. So now I can choose the reporting currency. So previously we had British pounds, but I can change that one nice and easily. For argument's sake, let's choose US dollars, and I can apply that one, and Joiin will perform those currency translations for me off the shelf. But equally, if you've got your own rates in mind, you can enter those within the settings. We then have the report filters box over here, which basically lets you decide how the report's broken down. So we can use our preset filters, so we could show this month or current and previous 3 months, or categories or classes. But in this instance, we're going to run a report by company. So this will give me a breakdown, as you'll see now, of company A, company B, and a total column. So in this instance, Saltram, Joiin Limited, and then the group total in this right-hand column over here. If at any point we want to kind of query any of these numbers or drill down on them, we can click on any figure within Joiin. So we've got this $12,000 here, which we can click on, and it will bring up all of the journals that make up these companies. You can see here we've got this first invoice line item for Joiin Limited for the 9th of April. And what we can do as well, we can click on this one and it will actually redirect us straight into the source software, and we can bring up the original financial document. So you can see here we've got the original Xero invoice. Really nice feature there to be able to drill down into those ones. So I'm going to go back on over to Joiin now, and I'm going to show you a few more features within the P&L very quickly. So I'm going to go back to this report over here. We have a budgeting tool, so I can choose to click on the budget tool and I can display my various budgets, which will be uploaded from Xero, QuickBooks or Sage automatically. So I'm just going to show my budget value and a budget variance as well for this report. I can choose that like so, and there you can see we've got my budgets and then a variance in green or red as well. We'll quickly turn that one off again. And I'm just going to take you through eliminations now very quickly. So basically, to manage your eliminations within Joiin, you can go to the settings icon and go to eliminations. So from this eliminations page, we can begin tagging our accounts that relate to intercompany balances within Joiin. So I'm going to press add elimination here. I can use this search box. I've got it laid out really nicely for myself. So if I search intercompany, it's going to show all of my intercompany accounts, which I've got nicely categorized. I can tag these ones here with this tick box, and I can choose to eliminate these ones because I'm happy that they are all intercompany balances. What I can do now is I can go back on over to Joiin, and I'll go to my P&L again, and I'm going to show you how we can manage those eliminations within Joiin and a couple of the different options available to us. So if we go to the top right corner, we've got this elimination configuration box, which we can open up. We've got four different options. So we've got show all accounts. So that's pretty simple. It temporarily turns off eliminations. You've got the remove eliminated accounts, which I'll show you in a moment. And then we've got the show eliminated accounts only, which will basically give us a view of just the accounts that we've tagged for elimination. So we can see here, we've got two accounts, this intercompany income in Joiin Limited and an intercompany expense in Saltram, and we can see that they tie off against each other, totaling to zero down here. So we're happy with these eliminations. So what we can do is we can actually go on over here and we can say, let's remove those eliminated accounts. And I can apply that. And now I've got a group P&L with my intercompany accounts removed. Now that I've shown you some of the off-the-shelf reporting, I'm going to quickly take you to custom reports. And I'm going to open up one of the templates that I've created previously. So this nice month-end P&L. So I'm just going to take you through very quickly some of the features within custom reports. So obviously the thing that will jump out at you first off is the charting. So you've got bar, donut and line charts available to you. You then have the formula tool, so you can use that to create custom KPIs or kind of general custom formulas. And then you've got the grouping tools. So you can see I've got a pretty summarized P&L here. I can open up some of these custom groups I've created. So I can open up this revenue group. And I can see I've got a couple of different subgroups in here, sales and subscriptions, which I can drill down on, or I can tuck them up back neatly within revenue. So that's a really nice tool there and can be used for remapping your chart of accounts and lining up your chart of accounts, which is something the majority of our users use it for. Once you've finished with your custom report, you can download it to Excel or PDF, or if you wanted to, you can add it to a report pack, which is basically Joiin's answer to board reporting, which I'll take you through now. So I'm going to navigate over to report packs now and open up this report pack that I've created previously and just show you what that one looks like. Okay, so this is one of the Joiin report packs. So lots of different things that you can do within here. You can add your company or client logo up here, like I've added the Joiin logo. Then you can add your own custom background, colors and branding and that sort of thing. So I'm going to scroll through and just show you here. So I've got a contents page. We've got my executive summary reports with just some nice notes and commentary on the overall health of my group. And then going through, we've got some KPI reporting against budget. Just giving you an example of some of the different reports you can create within Joiin as well. We've got a month-end P&L here, broken down by group. We've got some custom reports showing our bank balances, a consolidated balance sheet, a summary P&L, and finally another month-end P&L there. So I'm now going to go back on over to Joiin, and I'm going to highlight a couple of our other new features for you as well. So first off, I'm going to show you the global search feature, which I'm going to click on here. And this essentially gives you an option to search for any financial document, whether that be invoices, bills, payments, across your whole group, using a variety of parameters. Again, allowing you to kind of query any data in here. So you can open up a selection of companies to search from. So I'm going to search across these two companies. And I've got a couple of different other filters here, but I could search, for instance, by invoice number. So I could search for invoice 0020. I could use that search function. And again, I can find that particular invoice I wanted to query and open it up in Xero again. Then finally, we have the dashboard as well. So again, we've got a highly customizable dashboard here that can be tailored to your specific use case or your group's use case. And here I've just got some kind of key metrics that are particularly relevant to my group here. So I've got some revenue versus previous year, some cash in bank balances, and then some revenue against budget as well. Again, all customizable for you.
Thank you very much for watching our demo. Next steps will be to begin a Joiin trial, which you can do by going to our website, joiin.co, and pressing the free trial button. If you have any questions or would like to get in touch with a member of the support team, please feel free to do so by emailing us at support@joiin.co. Thank you very much. Take care.